Okay, so in a scenario like this, wherein you have an end device over here and you have two routers to go outside, assuming a scenario wherein if I say that you have one router and you have two router, both of your routers can take you on the internet. You have an option to go on the internet, and these two are connected to separate service providers. Sorry. This is my link that goes to the upstream cloud. But as of now, we are seeing some another scenario. Means what? See, these are my gateways. These are my gateways that will allow me to take me outside. Now, if you want to assign it a gateway, let us give it an IP addressing scheme 192.168.1.1 for router 1, 192.168.1.2, and let's say here 192.168.1.10. Which is the default gateway that you will assign to this PC over here so that he can go outside on the internet. So you have two options. You can choose this router or you can choose this router. But if you say this ISP is cheap, he gives me better connection. So you can choose this ISP and you can select default gateway as 1.1 over here. So this device will take this path to go on the upstream internet. But what if you say this link fails? So what will happen? Or what if you say we have many users? If I say there is not only one user, I have many people who are connected in my LAN segment. I have at least 200 users and they are taking this path. This path is being chosen and this path goes down. What will happen? We have to manually come in and we have to manually redirect these users. And we have to tell them, kindly change your default gateway to 1.2 because the link that was going to the router has failed. So your end users have to be told. See, in the event, if you have no connectivity, your data will not pass and you have to face downtime. So what happens is you cannot afford to do that. So, okay, no problem. If taking a scenario wherein I change the default gateway and I take this path, no worries. But what if this link comes up and this link is still down, if this link goes down? And again, so if this link goes down, you have to shift back. You have to keep on changing your default gateways every now and then, right? And that is not good. So to avoid this, we have something called first hop redundancy protocols. Here we have three protocols: HSRP, VRRP, and GLBP. What are these GLBP? What are these protocols for? To provide us redundancy on the first hop. Means here, they will provide us redundancy over here. Now, what is the use of these redundancy protocols? They will simulate a virtual router in between. Now, what will happen is, they too will act as if there is a virtual router in between them. So anytime you want to go outside, you will not give the IP address of the physical router. No, you will give the IP address of this virtual router. For example, if I say 192.168.1.254. Now, what will these protocols help us to do? So if I want to go outside, I will not choose this physical router. I will choose this virtual router, and these two routers will act as if there is a virtual router, and they will forward the data to for this one IP address. Now in this HSRP, HSRP is hot standby router protocol. Hot standby router protocol means this one guy will be active. Active means actively he will forward the data. So you will just send the data related to this IP address. But the active router will take the data and he will send it out. This is virtual. If this link goes down, this router will understand they are sending hellos with each other on these links. So what will happen is, if this router goes down, he will not send hellos on these links. This router will detect it and he will say, oh, my other router is down. I need to become active and I will forward the data destined to this IP address. So you will not have downtime. Your router's links can go down, but you will always be reachable with your default gateway. HSRP is Cisco's proprietary routing protocol, redundancy protocol. You have two more redundancy protocols like this: VRRP and GLBP. We'll discuss about them later on, but what is the use of this protocol? sorry. So if I say, let us revise a little bit again. If I say I want to select a default gateway, I can select a physical default gateway, or else see, for if this default gateway goes down, then I have to manually configure. HSRP allows us to configure a virtual IP, and so there will be no need for us to use these physical routers. Let us see how to implement this. Implementing is very simple. First, we will assign basic IP addresses on the router, physical here, 192.168.1.10. Gateway, you will select as 1.254. Why 1.254? 1.254 will be the logical address of these routers, you can say. As of now, I'll just write it in Notepad. What will be our commands? Enable configure terminal interface G0/0. IP address will be 192.168.1.1 for router 1, not 0. Let's give it a host name also. Host name is router 1, and I will say no shutdown to it. As of now, we are not doing anything. We are simply giving IP addresses. So I just gave a basic address on the gigabit 0/0. I'll say control A, control C. Let's paste these addresses over here. So I am just giving the physical interface an address, nothing much, an IP address over here. Similarly, I will give an IP address over here also. This is my router 2. This is 1.2, and I just will say no shutdown to this one. So we have a basic topology wherein I just have one PC and two gateways, but which gateway should I select, right? So we will not use these physical addresses. This is 1.2, this is 1.1, and this is 1.2. I will not use the physical addresses of these routers. I will create HSRP between them, and they both will start acting as if there is a virtual router in between. So what will be the command to activate HSRP? It is very simple. Just go on the interface that connects to the LAN. Remember one thing, all the commands will be pasted on gigabit 0/0, the interface that connects to the LAN. You have to say standby 1. The standby 1 is the group number, and it must match on both the sides. And here you will say virtual IP is 1.254. Simple as that. You will just say standby 1 IP over here and give it the virtual IP address. What is the virtual IP address? This is the virtual IP that these both will forward the data for. So your default gateway will be this. Let us copy this and let us paste it over here. On both the routers, you will have the same commands, nothing different. Interface gigabit 0/0, standby 1 IP. So what will he do? He will start sending hellos. What is hello? Hello, the protocol. He will start sending hellos after every 3 seconds. Similarly on this one. So let us say configure terminal interface gigabit 0/0. Only one command is what you are learning today. Just one command saying standby 1 IP. Standby 1 IP, this is the IP address of the logical router, and there are 4 states of HSRP. Let us say standby, listen, speak, and active. Show standby. See, speak and standby. So show standby 1, or show standby, if you say show standby, will tell you how HSRP is being configured. So it says your gigabit 0/0 is in group number 1. My state is standby. Virtual IP address is this, means I will forward the data. This is the MAC address. Excuse me. So if you say you have a virtual router will have a virtual IP. It will also have a virtual MAC address. So this is the MAC address that you will see. And hellos are sent after 3 seconds. And hold time is generally 3 times more. So hello is sent after 3 seconds. Hold is after 10 seconds. See, in HSRP, you have such a huge power that you can have sub-second failover also. Means you can send hellos 1 second, 5 hellos in 1 second. And there is something called preemption. I'll tell you what is this. But as of now, active router is 1.1. And I am the standby. My priority by default is 100. Both will have the same priority. But let us see the behavior. Let me check. Can I reach the default gateway? Ping 192.168.1.254. I am not contacting the physical router's interfaces. I am contacting the virtual IP address over here. ARP space minus A. See here, the physical address. So who is replying for this physical address? It is the active router. Right? So my data is going from here. If, for example, if I say, how is the data, what is the path for the data to travel? Now, this is the active router, because I saw this is the active router. And if I want to go outside, I will use the default gateway. But I don't know who is the default gateway. These two devices are acting as there is a default gateway, and he is the one who is sending data outside. So this is the use of our first hop redundancy protocols, you can say. What are they used for? To provide us redundancy on this first hop for us. Now, what if? Now, the basic implementation is just one command. It is standby one IP and both start acting. What if there is a failure? So we saw that this is the active router and this is the standby router. What if the link to the active router fails? My gateway should not go down, right? As of now, he is the active router. He will forward the data. But what I want, why are we using HSRP? Automatic failover should happen. My default gateway should not go down at all. Now, what I will do is, see, implementation is done. Now, let us test it. I will simply start a continuous ping to 254. Continuous ping means I will not stop the ping. By default, ping will use around 4 to 5 packets, you can say. So this guy will send the data to 254 and this active router, we will turn it down. Let us see if this guy forwards the data. Let's go on this one and let us say ping hyphen T. This is the testing ping, non-stop ping. This will not stop the ping until and unless we do not tell it to. I will simply go and say this one. See, listen, speak, standby, active, four states. What I'll do is do show standby. It says I am the active router, means he is actively forwarding the data. I will simply go on interface gigabit 0/0. I will say shut this interface down. I shut this interface down and see what happens over here. See, request is timing out. This PC is sending the data to the default gateway, but the default gateway is not reachable. What should happen is HSRP. This failover will be detected by the other router and see, the reply starts coming. Now, what happened over here? This was the router one who was replying. The router one's physical interface went down. So he stopped replying for 254. After a few seconds, after 10 seconds technically, router 2 saw that router 1 is down and router 2 starts sending the data to the destined to the default gateway. See here, the downtime was around 10 seconds. Why? Because of the hold timer. You can tune HSRP to say, okay, just 1 second. If I say, if you detect 1 second also, if he does not send a hello for 1 second, immediately start forwarding the data. You can see in high frequency trading environments, you will need to change the hello timers also. You can also change the hello timers by simply saying interface gigabit 0/0, and you can say standby one timers, and you can change the timers by this also. So this is a very basic implementation of HSRP. The thing that we saw in here was that HSRP allows us to have redundancy towards the end gateways, right? You have redundancy till here. Tell me one thing. If your this link is fine, this link is also fine. See, for example, if router one is the active router, he is sending the data upstream. The data is going very fine. What if the uplink fails? See, if the uplink will fail, the hellos are continuously sent. Hellos are received by this. So why will he take the active position, if the router is sending hellos, the uplink is and uplink is failed, the gateway is reachable, internet is not reachable. See, this guy sends the data to the gateway, but the gateway is fine. After the gateway, the internet router is down. What can you do? So in this scenario, there is some another implementation. Let us see that in a moment.